Triangle Talk Show. I am Bhavya. Today, the global educationalist, Mr. Manoj Geeta, is with us. A wonderful welcome to you, sir.
It's my pleasure, Bhavya. Thank you.
Sir, can you just explain that what are the qualities of a good teacher, or what can we expect from a teacher?
You know, teacher's job, as we always hear, is a very noble job. And when we talk about qualities of a good teacher, I would not like to give a big list, but maybe two, three things. And the first and the foremost important thing I feel is that you need to love your profession. You need to love children. If you really love your profession, if you really love children, that's the first quality I think that a good teacher will have. And naturally, a good teacher will be a very good planner. A good teacher will never enter the classroom without proper lesson plans, proper material planning, you know. So loving your students, loving your vocation, that's the first quality, as I understand. Second, plan your lessons well, plan your lessons very effectively. And third, today there is an explosion of knowledge. So a good teacher has to continuously keep upgrading their knowledge by reading, by exploring various websites and various sources of knowledge. These three, I think, are the most important qualities of a good and effective teacher.
Sir, according to you, which way is more effective for teaching learning process, like cramming the things or concept based?
It's a very good question, Bhavya. Unfortunately, in our country, these days, the whole focus is on passing the exams or scoring 90%, 98% in the exams. So unfortunately, the focus of education has become exam and not the learning. Now, I'm not against scoring good marks in the exam. We should score, and our children are capable to score those good marks. But the problem is, you do not need one full year to prepare for the exam. So spend all that time towards understanding, towards learning, towards helping your students to develop conceptual clarity. And then towards the end, if you really want to focus on the exam, you can focus on the exam. But throughout the year, just doing memorization, rote learning, and then vomiting it out on the exam day is very bad. It's not education. And I'm really sorry if that is being practiced by our teachers.
Sir, according to you, how can a teacher carry out the multitasking?
I always say the teacher's job is not a 7 or 8 hours job. Teacher's job is a 24 hours job. A good teacher, even when he or she is sleeping, is a teacher. They have to continuously keep thinking and worrying and planning about what are they going to. And again, I would link it with the qualities that if you are happy as a teacher, if you are loving your vocation, you will always be innovative, you will be always learning, you will always be trying to make your class very interesting and very fun for the children. But as I said, it's not 8 hours job, it's a full-time job. And if you love it, it will not be a burden on your shoulders, you know.
So do you think in the last few years, the relationship between teacher and student has been changed?
Definitely. We get to hear about the unfortunate incidences happening inside the classrooms in the schools, where this harmonious relationship between the teacher and the child are breaking up. And somehow again, I would link it with the stress that is being put on our teachers from the management, from the parents, and the whole unnecessary focus on just passing the exam. If the purpose of the education is learning, if the purpose of the education is fun of learning, enjoyment of learning, then naturally the relationship between the child and the teacher will also go on a very different trajectory.
So sir, for teachers, mostly teachers, producing the best result is the task. And all the teachers are judged on their results. So according to you, the results is the only criteria for teachers to prove themselves?
Bhavya, as I said, it is very unfortunate. And our teachers are being victim of this system where the focus is only and only on the exams and passing exams and securing scores. This way, we are killing the innovation and the enthusiasm of the teacher. We are putting unnecessary stress on them, not only on them, also on the students and on the parent. And I think we, the planners of the education, are responsible for that. Our children are capable to score good marks. Our teachers are capable to produce good results. But that cannot be the only focus of education. Education is character building. Education is personality development of the child, the holistic development of the child. Just passing the exam is not education, Bhavya, and we need to get out of this mindset. I strongly believe in that.
Sir, is it important for teachers to learn the psychology so that they can deal with the students easily?
Definitely. You know, because teachers are dealing with live human beings. They have emotions, they have feelings. And the teacher who has understood, studied psychology, they would be very naturally comfortable to handle and establish very harmonious and fruitful relationship with the child on one-to-one basis and also with the children as a group. And that's why I think in all good teacher education institutions, there is a huge focus on learning, understanding child psychology, and then developing your lessons, developing your educational practices based on the understanding of the child psychology.
So during the exams, students should be given important question or the whole syllabus?
Again, I understand, because we are again going back to the same question of exam and preparation, because that's how the whole society is pushing us towards. I believe, I have been teacher for last 30 years, and I strongly believe that a good teacher who has planned the syllabus and the classes throughout the year very effectively, they don't need to worry about preparing children for exam. When you prepare children for learning, when you prepare children for the conceptual understanding, naturally the child will have that confidence, and that confidence will automatically reflect when the child appears in the examination. So to me, that focus needs to shift from the exam to the joy of learning. Then you will not have stress, and then you'll be able to help them perform better in their life, in their exams as well, you know.
So like a student, when there is an exam for the student, there is equal stress on the teachers too. Yeah. So how can the teachers overcome that stress?
Right now, as I say, because the focus is so limited, and that's why the stress is happening at every level, at the teacher's level, at the parents' level, and also at the child level. In the new education system, which we are trying to introduce here at Spangle, we are trying to prepare our children for a larger life role. That doesn't mean that we are not focusing on securing good marks in the exam. It's just 10%, 20% of education. There is much more to education than that. And unless the whole focus changes from only looking at the exam to looking at the whole fun and joy of education, the stress will continue, you know.
Sir, like you have been many foreign places, So what is the their teaching methods?
In developing countries, in developing world, there is a focus on innovation of learning, joy of learning. Students are allowed to ask questions. Unfortunately, in our system, sometimes we do not promote this asking of questions. We always want them to keep quiet and keep listening. My request to teachers is, a good teacher encourages lots and lots of questions from children. Because this inquisitive mind, this creativity will help the child to develop into a very creative human being. Our children are very intelligent, but if we do not allow them to ask questions, if you always tell, listen to your elders, do not talk, do as I say, they will become dabboos, you know, they will not brighten up. So that, I think, that opportunity we need to give, and we need to plan our lessons in such a way where children get opportunity to ask as many questions as they want to ask.
So what is your thinking about the competition between the teachers? Like giving the question, like sometimes there is a competition between the teachers. A teacher won't their student to get good marks. So they leak the question papers and all other things. So what is your saying in this?
Well, Bhavya, competition is not a bad thing. But it should be healthy competition. It should be, I would say it's like you are competing to do better as a team. You are not competing to outsmart each other in applying some illegal methods. That's not the way. I'm not against the competition, but this will again depend on where the focus is. If the focus is very limited, that okay, I want my subject should, all the students should get maximum marks in my subject, then this unhealthy illegal means will be applied of leaking question papers or trying illegal means to help your students. Once we are broadening the focus of education, once we are helping teachers and children and the system to start enjoying the, you know, the fun of learning, the pleasure of being in the school, then naturally this competition, which is quite unhealthy these days, that problem will be sorted. I think that way, you know.
So like students also have problem from teachers. Like if a teacher is not helping them in the perfect way that they can, so what can be done in this case?
Again, I will bring the question to the relationship issue, relationship between the child and the teacher. A good teacher knows his or her children individually as persons. When you deal with a child in the classroom, your responsibility is not just imparting the knowledge or whatever skills you want to impart. You need to also look at the child as a human being. Understand the child holistically as a person. Support them emotionally, support them socially, understand them, talk to them. Then naturally, once you start looking at the child in a holistic perspective, tackling the educational aspect, academic aspect, is not a big job. A teacher can easily do it, you know.
So now, I would like to conclude this episode of Spangle Talk Show. Sir, would you like to say anything more?
I have lots of faith in my teachers. I know each and every teacher is capable to perform well. I know each and every teacher has capacity to help their students excel in education. Please do not get flustered by the demand of this unnatural education system that is being created. Enjoy your teaching. Enjoy your vocation. Love your children. Work hard. There are no shortcuts in life. You need to prepare well. Even after spending 30 years in education system, I will never be going to any class without preparing. Prepare well. Do your classes. Enjoy your teaching. Love your children, you will love your life. That's the message I think I would like to give to all my teachers whom I respect so much, you know.
Thank you, sir, for being with us.
It's my pleasure, Bhavya. Thank you.
Now I would like to wrap this episode of Spangle Talk Show. We will meet again in the new episode of Spangle Talk Show with a new guest and a new topic. Till then, goodbye, take care.